Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are having a wonderful day. Today we're going to do a get ready with me, so I hope you guys are ready to sit down and do your makeup or just carry me along with you like I do typically. I put like my YouTube videos on my phone and I carry my phone around and listen to it while I'm doing like house chores and stuff. So if you guys are interested, that's what I'm doing today is a get ready with me. I need to grab my brushes. I forgot my brushes over here. So let's grab these. I need eye brushes. Probably not going to be able to do an eye look without eye brushes. What do you think? So I'm going to get started by first setting my skin. So I'm going to use the Fresh Vitamin Nectar Antioxidant Water, Glow Water. It's like a water that you put on. It smells really good, but it's like a spritzer, but it almost comes out like an aerosol can. This was sent to me complimentary from Fresh, so I'm excited about using this. This is something that I honestly had no idea was even on the market. If you guys knew about this, let me know if you've tried it before. So for me, I really like it because of how fine the mist is. So I like to put it on before I do my makeup because you guys know I do have extremely dry skin. So I like to make sure that my skin is nice and hydrated. Give it as much hydration as I possibly can. I like to use this throughout the day as well because it just feels like a nice refresher. So this is really nice. I am enjoying that very much so. Now I'm going to go ahead and prime my skin. And the primer I'm going to use is somewhere in here. I've lost it. I lost my primer. Do you guys ever do that? Like you get everything ready and you're like, yep, I didn't forget. I forgot some things. I think I lost my primer. So I'm just going to use the Dr. Dart Cicapair. This is the Tiger Grass Color Correcting Treatment. So I like to use this because I do have a lot of redness. I don't know if you can see it or not, but there's a lot of redness going on my skin. I still have some acne breakouts and some acne scars. So let's see if we can cover those up a little bit. So this is my smaller container that I use the bigger container to put it into. So either I'm not dipping my finger always in the bigger container. So I like to use this to help to get rid of any of the redness. It really does help with the redness, but it's not very hydrating. So if you need something hydrating, I don't think this is going to be just enough for you. So definitely use something else for hydration. But I like to wear this by itself sometimes. I'll just put this on and then go out. And then I feel like my skin just looks a little bit better. It doesn't look so blotchy and red. I don't know if you can tell the difference or not, but it's definitely toning it down in person. I can see a big difference. So just put some of this on and see if this helps with the redness in my skin. So if you guys have some exciting plans for the weekend, I'd love to know what you guys are doing. We are gonna be camping, I think. I think we're gonna camp tonight. So I'm a little nervous about it because we haven't camped in a while. We do have like a camper and everything, but I'm just worried because we have a camper that we let other people use as well. And I'm just worried because the person that stayed there the last time said that they saw a snake. And I'm like, I do not like snakes. So I'm paranoid. I'm like, do not let me see a snake because I'm going to be screaming and running. So that is me. You'll see just dust in the wind. So the next thing I'm going to use is by Pure. This is the Pure 4-in-1 Love Your Selfie Longwear Foundation and Concealer. This was also sent to me complimentary from Pure and Octoly. So the way that this works is that it is a concealer. So if you unscrew the top here, you have like a doe foot applicator attached to it, which is really interesting because it's still a pump type of foundation, but it's got a doe foot applicator at the bottom. So it's very interesting how that works. But then the pump, of course, is right here. So I'm just going to pump some of this into the brush that was also sent to me by Pure. This is the Pure, I can't remember, I think it's like the Wonder Brush. I can't remember exactly what it's called. It'll be in the description box for you guys. But this was also sent to me complimentary just to test out to see if I enjoy it or not. So what I like to do with it is go ahead and pump two pumps into this little silicone spot. So two pumps into there and then start putting it onto my skin. I like to kind of like space it out first and then go back and just do the coverage. I typically, you guys know, I usually use a beauty blender to do my makeup, but this actually works pretty good. I'm not great with a brush for makeup because I feel like you can still see the brush strokes. So I'll have to probably go in and pat it out with a beauty blender just to make sure there are no brush strokes. If I'm doing this wrong, that's because I'm not used to doing, I don't usually do a brush for makeup application, so I'm probably not going to be perfect at it. So probably don't follow my instructions for how I'm using it. If you probably are someone who likes to use brushes a little bit more than I do, you probably have way more better ideas on how to use this better than I do. So, but I think for even with my lack of knowledge on using a brush, I think it still looks really good. What do you guys think? I think it just looks so even on my skin. All of the redness is completely gone. You can't see any of that. And that was just two pumps in this brush. The only redness I still see is right here above my nose, like right there in that spot. That's all I see. So I think it's a really cool tool. I'm just gonna bring it down my neck a little bit because my neck and my skin is not the same color. My face and my body matches because I did self-tan, but my neck is not the same color. So I don't self-tan my neck and I don't self-tan my face just because I do have acne issues. So I'm afraid if I would use a self-tanner on my face that I probably would end up getting more acne issues, and that's not exactly what I'm looking for in life. So that is it for that. So if you guys can see, I think it looks really good on the skin though. I think it looks very natural. If I wanted to go in now, I could go in and use the little doe foot applicator and get rid of any of the acne scars that are still kind of popping through a little bit. So you can take your little doe foot applicator on the pure foundation and concealer and cover those up. And then if I wanted to use the brush again, I could, or you could go in with a beauty blender. I'm going to go in with the beauty blender just to tap it in, or not a beauty blender. This is a Real Technique sponge. Just going to tap it in like that. And because it's the same color as the foundation, it blends out really well and it seems to not look so odd, in my opinion, versus using a concealer where it's a completely different color. Sometimes it can be really like pale compared to your foundation and then it just like pops out like a sore thumb. So that's the great thing about that as well. Now I'm going to set my lids, and you guys are probably know what I'm going to use to set my lids. My favorite product ever for setting my lids is the MAC Painterly Paint Pot. This is the really old one. It's the one I think is about had it. It's time to probably get rid of it. But it's like the never ending pot of concealer, honestly, because it just keeps it going. And honestly, all I did to make it kind of revived a little bit, I used the, what are they called? It's like these drops. I think it's cut by Inglot. I'm pretty sure that's who it's by. I can't remember. But they're these drops you put in and then it just kind of like hydrates everything back up for you. And then I just mixed it around with a little spatula and it was good to go again. So I'm like, it still works for me. Still works. The reason why I like this though so much, the MAC Painterly Paint Pot, is because it's got a little bit of a tacky, sticky base. I don't know if you can tell it or not, but my fingers are kind of sticking to my eyeball where I'm patting it on because it's got that tacky, sticky base, which is perfect for putting your foundation, or your foundation, your eyeshadows over top. So Alter Ego sent me two palettes. They sent me the Goddess palette, which I honestly didn't even use this week. I was more interested in the Daydream. The Goddess palette is the same thing as the Natasha Denona gold palette, so I think I'm going to do a comparison of those later. But this one right here is the Daydream, and this one is the same thing as the Huda Beauty New Nudes palette. I did do them side by side, and I will be doing a comparison for both palettes later on. But right now, today, we're just going to use the Alter Ego one. So this is the Alter Ego Daydream palette. It's really good. I really didn't have to even use a primer because there is a sticky base in here. It's like a creamy base in here that I could have used as well. So I could have used that, but honestly, I forgot. So we're going to go ahead and go in with the first shadow, which is Glow. I'm going to use that to set all over my lids. And I'm going to use my color switch. Some of you guys were asking me about the color switch, like how long does it last? So basically, the color switch, you can use this for a very, very long time. All you have to do is pull this little mesh part out. So that comes completely out. You wash that, wash your little tin can out, let it all dry out very good, and then stick it back in. You're good to go again. So I love the color switch. I think it's perfect for like using, if you don't want to use a bunch of brushes, you just want to use a few, it's perfect for being able to do that. So that way there, it just takes the color off of the brush. It doesn't actually clean the brush, you know what I'm saying? So it just cleans it enough so that you can use it through different colors. You could go from like this light color right here all the way to a dark, and then you could go back to the light and it wouldn't mix because you would have color switched it off. So it works really good for that. So this shadow right here again is Glow. I just think it looks really good for setting my lids. It's a little powdery. It's got a little bit of kick up, nothing extreme. So I like the way it looks. I'm not going to do anything super crazy today because honestly, I'm just too hot. It is hot here today for some reason. I'm like, my kids are back to school now, so now it needs to like cool down because it seems like whenever it's back to school time, it should be cooler weather. But my kids went back like extremely early. Well, my son did. My youngest son, he went back extremely early. So I'm going to use Sunset now, which is like a peachy pinky tone, like a mauve, I guess, or like a mauve, however you pronounce it. So I'm going to tap that off, and this is the Ipsy and Tetris brush that I got in that set that I purchased. So I'm going to use a little bit of that to start carving out a crease. Caprice color. My eyelids are getting so wrinkly. My age is starting to really show. I'm like, oh my goodness. Growing old. It's happening. It's happening. I don't know if it might be TMI, but I'm like, I think I might be getting close to menopause or something because I'm getting like heat stroke. Not heat strokes. Goodness gracious, no. I'm getting like hot flashes. So like I'll wake up and like my hair is like soaking wet from sleeping and then I'm like really hot throughout the day and then I get really cold. I'm like, oh my gosh, I think I'm getting close to menopause. My mom hit menopause, I think right about 42-ish and I'm 41. So am I 41? Yeah, I'm 41. I was like, I had to think for a second. How old are you? I don't know. I forget some days, believe it or not. I don't know about you guys, but I forget my own age sometimes. I don't forget my kids' age. I forget my own age, which is really weird. You would think, if anything, I would forget my kids' age. I guess because that was such a exciting day, though. The day you have your children is so exciting. You are mommies out there, you probably know what I mean. Or if you're trying to conceive a child, you probably know what I mean. It's just so exciting to bring a baby into the world. My sister-in-law and my brother, they're trying to have a baby, but they've been trying for a very long time and they've had no success. She did get pregnant, but they ended up losing the baby. So I know how that feels because I did end up having a miscarriage after my second son. We had my tubes tied after I had my second son. And then I regretted it like big time because I was like, you know what? I really think I wanted to try for three children. I really wanted that extra child. So we had my tubes reversed. So we went to Charlottesville in Virginia and I had my tubes reversed. So I'm gonna go in now to Fawn. So when we went there, they did a procedure where they checked to make sure that everything would be able to do it. So they check your records and they found out that they could reverse my tubes on one side because at first they thought they could do it on both sides. Because the doctor in his notes wrote that he left the tube lengths pretty long. But then once he got into it, he realized that he couldn't because the doctor kind of fudged the op notes. So my one side, my right side, he couldn't fix because the tube length was way too small. But then he was able to fix the left side. So I still had one tube that was only 4 centimeters. No, it was 4 centimeters long is how long the tube length is. It was extremely short because I think normal tube length is like 10 centimeters. If this is like TMI, you guys will have to tell me, but I'm just like talking about it now. And I'm like, I want to finish my story. Do you guys ever do that? You start a story and you're like, I got to finish it. Okay. So anyway, he fixed one side and then they did this whole, we had to wait like a while for me to heal up and everything because they have to cut you open and everything to do all that. Once I was healed, they did like this dye test to make sure the tube was working and the tube was working perfectly. So they were very happy with that. Now we're gonna go over to, let's see. I'm gonna go over to this one right here, which is Bubbly. So I'm gonna use Bubbly and I'm just gonna go up above the crease a little bit. So anyway, he tested the tubes and they were working perfectly. And he said that he thought we could have success at getting pregnant. So we tried for about 6 months and then nothing really happened. And then we were put on Clomid, which is a fertility drug to help make you make more eggs. So, or help you more to be more, I think it's more eggs is what it makes you do. I'm pretty sure that's what it is, to be honest with you. I forget because it's been so long now. But anyway, I remember they put us on Clomid and we tried that for a little bit and then I ended up getting pregnant. So I got pregnant and I was so, so, so excited. And then a little while after getting pregnant, I very quickly lost the baby. So I didn't carry the baby very long at all. So then they offered to do IVF for us and we thought about it, doing IVF and everything. But honestly, I don't know. I felt really weird about doing it. And everybody has their own opinions on like how to have children and everything. But for some reason, I just couldn't bring myself to, first of all, spend that much money because it's a lot to do IVF. And I already have two perfectly healthy children. And I'm like, I want us to be able to send them to college and do the things that they need to do in life. So I was like, look, let's just let happen what happens. And unfortunately, I think I made the wrong decision. I think I should have done IVF because now that I'm 41, I don't think I want to do IVF. And of course, we didn't get pregnant again. So that was our only shot at getting pregnant and we didn't succeed. We lost the baby, but So I do know how my sister-in-law feels. It's very hard to try to have a baby. It's extremely hard. I'm going into Starcrossed, which is down here. I'm gonna use that to tap on the lid. So it is extremely hard to have a baby, especially when you're trying so hard. It feels like, and then not only that, it seems like when you are trying to have a baby, it seems like everybody around you gets pregnant and you're like, it's not that you are envious of them. It's just that you're like, why, what am I doing wrong? Why can't I get pregnant? And you start to wonder what the world you've done to not be able to get the thing that you're wanting so badly. So you start to kind of blame yourself a little bit. So for her, I love her to pieces, and I hope that they do end up getting pregnant, because I think everybody deserves the chance to be a mom. If you want to be a mom in life, you deserve that right to have a child. So I hope they get pregnant eventually. But anyway, that was a very long story, and I am sorry, but I just thought I'd share my little fertility issue with you guys. Now I'm going to use the Benefit Cabrow. I'm going to use this to do my brows quickly with. I'm just going to give them a little bit of shading here. Need to flip my mirror. I did get an extra mirror now, so I don't have to, whoa, holy smokes. This is like the side that like increases, like, what is it, magnification? So like my face looks like a pumpkin head now, literally. So I can definitely see though, which is good. So I can see if I goof up on my brows or not. I'm sure I will. Cause this here, I haven't used in a while, and it's, the brush of this is so tiny. That's the only thing I don't like about this product here, is that the brush is so, so tiny. I probably could use my own brush. Let's try that. It's probably a better idea. Let's do that. Let me set this down for a second, and I'll clean off my brush right here. This is the It Cosmetics one. I'm just gonna clean it off pretty good with the color switch. I was gonna say Beauty Blender. It's not a Beauty Blender. So I'm gonna clean that off, and then I'm gonna use my brush here to dip into it. Hopefully this will be a little bit easier. Dip, 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 dip. Okay. Yeah, there we go. Much better at holding the brush too. I just don't like the applicator tool to the Benefit one, because it's just so, so small, and I have big hands. I remind myself sometimes of, if you guys have ever watched Seinfeld, there's an episode on Seinfeld where he's dating a girl, she's got pretty big hands, and that's me. So he's dating a girl, she's got pretty big hands, and like she goes to wipe his face off or something, and he thinks she's got man hands, and I'm like, yep, that's me. I have man hands and a pumpkin head. Some people think I'm kidding when I say that, but I really do have like a pretty large size head, because like if I try to wear like my husband's hat, I have to adjust it to make it bigger, because my head is a big head. I'm like big head. So I remember when I was pregnant with my boys too, that's another thing. I remember being a little bit leery, because I'm like, oh my gosh, their heads are probably going to be big like mine. How in the world? But I ended up having C-sections when I had both of them, so I didn't have to worry about the problem of trying to push them out, I guess. Even though with my oldest son, I was in labor for like 15 hours. I think it was 15 hours. I was in labor with him for 15 hours, and then they ended up taking him by C-section because they gave me the epidural. And as soon as they gave me the epidural, his heart rate plummeted. So they were like, they had to do an emergency, which was unfortunate because it was my first child. And then nobody was allowed to come back with me when I was having him. So it was really scary. I was like, it's scary to have a child in the first place and then not have anybody be allowed to come back with you. It's like, what? Why not? So it was very intimidating. All right, now I'm going to go in with my Real Techniques brush. I'm going to clean it off and the color switch as well. You can clean your big brushes off in here. You can clean your small brushes off. The big brushes are a little bit harder to get all the product off, but you can get a good majority. So just kind of like poke around, swirl around. You can get a good majority of it off. So I'm going to use the Lancome. This is called the La French Glow. This is in Light Liberté. This was also sent to me complimentary by Lancome and Octoly. So I'm just going to tap into here and start giving myself a little bit of bronzy glow. Do you see how pretty this is? Like, this is gorgeous. I just mix all the colors together. I don't really go in specifically for one. I just kind of do them all. And just do kind of the number three is what I do. Everybody bronzes, like, I feel like most people bronze way better than I can, so my bronzing skills are not the best. So probably, again, I'm more or less just like gonna show you all the things that like maybe you could do differently, basically. So we're just gonna put some bronzer on and give myself a little bit of bronze. I would put some on my shoulders too. This looks so pretty. I love this color. I think it's absolutely gorgeous the way it blends together, and it just looks very natural. It doesn't look artificial whatsoever once you put it onto your skin, which is what I like about it. I hate when I put a bronzer on and it starts to like almost look muddy on your skin. It's like, or it's like really bright red or bright like an orange, and then I'm like, oh my gosh, I look like an Oompa Loompa now. So those are the two things I always look out for. What is on my nose? Oh, I don't know what happened there, but I somehow must have scraped off my foundation or something, because you can see a red spot there for some reason. Okay, so that part is done. Now I'm going to go in with concealer. I'm just going to use the Pure 4-in-1, the concealer that's at the bottom of this. I'm just going to use a little bit of this to show you guys how it works. So I'm going to use that for concealing under my eyes. Of course, it's not going to brighten because it's the same color as my foundation, but it's going to help to conceal any darkness that I have though, so which is the thing that I worry about, because my husband always asks me, he's like, are you getting enough sleep? You have really dark circles under your eyes. And I'm like, yeah, I think it's because I am partially anemic, so I think that's what the issue is, why my dark circles have gotten worse. Well, I'm not partially anemic. I am anemic. So, and I think especially when it's, you know, Flo, Aunt Flo is here, or Dot, or whatever everybody likes to call their friend that comes for a visit. Whenever that's here, I usually have darker circles, for I guess because of losing more blood. So my iron level drops. So I was on iron pills and everything for a while because my iron level was extremely low. But I went off of those, which probably I should go back on because I'm starting to get that tired feeling again. I'm starting to feel kind of sluggish. And I'm thinking maybe I want to try them out again because they did work really well. They gave me lots of energy. The only thing was I had to make sure I got the ones that were mixed with vitamin C, because the ones that are mixed with vitamin C help to make sure that you still are able to use the restroom, because that was the one thing that was the hardest for me, is when you take an iron tablet, you can't do number two, which is very unfortunate. So I might have to try those again, because I personally don't like being able to, I don't like being constipated. I don't know about you guys, but like that's like the worst thing for me ever, is trying to use the bathroom and you can't because you've taken a pill that's supposed to help you with other things, and then you're like messing up other parts of your system. Do you see what I mean? It's like a lose-lose situation, or no, like a win-lose, I guess, because you're not losing. You're still winning. You're just not winning in the way that you would love to, because you would like to fix your iron issue, but also, you know, go to the bathroom. Who doesn't want to use the bathroom when you need to? So anyway, I'm having a hard time opening this thing up. Okay, so now I'm just going to put a little powder under my eyes. I'm using the Ciate. This is the Extraordinary, the powder. So that's what I'm using today to go under my eyes here. I'm going to use that. And then I'm also going to combine it with the Too Faced. This is the Do You. So I'm doing both, because I've noticed this one here kind of makes it look a little bit too powdery. So if I mix this one first and then do the Ciate one, then it's not as bad. I don't know why, but it just does. So I do a little bit of both. Even though it's not like an extreme amount, because you guys see I'm just putting like barely any powder here. I'm just kind of making it to a point where it just feels like you can smooth under your eyes again, versus when you have just foundation there, it's kind of like tacky and drags. So if I do both, then it doesn't do that. So a little of both here, especially in this area right here. This is where I seem to start to lose a lot of the concealer. So that's where I try to do more at, right there. All right, so that is that part. My eyes look not that great. I probably could do a little bit better work there. So let's go ahead and do a little bit more color on my eyes. So I'm going to go back into the Daydream palette. I'm going to go into this one right here, which is Sunset. Tap it off, and I'm just going to bring it up a little bit higher. I do have kind of like hooded eyes, so I like to try to bring it up as high as I possibly can without bringing it completely to my eyebrow. Just because when I do have my eyes like rested, it's hard to see the actual colors if I just put it on regular. Because like if I have it regular, like it's hard to see this eye. So I want to bring it up just a little bit further. Just a little bit. And then I'll go in and do like a little bit of, not really concealing, but just highlighting under my brow bone with a little bit with the Glow shade. So I'm going to use that one. And with the, my brushes are all mixed up. I can't find anything in here. I don't know what I've done to my brush container. Who knows? All right, so I'm gonna use this brush right here. This is the Luxie Mini Angled Brush. It's like a glittery one. So I'm gonna use that and do my brow bone. Same thing on the other side. And we're good. So there's what that looks like. And now I'm going to go ahead and curl my lashes. I bet I didn't grab my eyelash curler. Did I not? I don't see it. I don't see it over there hanging either, though. That's what's worrisome, because I don't see it anywhere. Lost it. So that's awesome. So we won't be curling my lashes. I'm just going to go directly in with the mascara. So the mascara I chose to use for this week is the Balm Scuba Mascara. So this one is a water-resistant one. I don't love water-resistant mascaras, but we'll give it a shot and see how she does. I do like the wand, though, because it's really tiny. So you guys know I'm not good with mascara, so anytime that they can make the wand super tiny, it does help me out a little bit so I don't get it all over my eyelid. That's always helpful. So anyways, like I was saying, we are going camping, I think, tonight. So you guys are going to have to wish me luck, because I don't know if I want to sit outside too long if there's going to be snakes running around. No, I'm not that scared. We do live in the woods too, so I'm used to seeing snakes. I'm just petrified of snakes. Especially, I think it's like the scare factor of them, because it's not really that I'm scared if I see one like far away. That doesn't really scare me. It's that you're sitting somewhere or you're like walking somewhere and all of a sudden there's a snake. And then you're like, oh my gosh, it's like really scary. So what is the animal that you guys are most afraid of? Snakes and spiders are mine. Those are my two things that I'm really petrified of. I would like to get over that fear. If you guys have any suggestions on how to get over like fears and things, that's something I would love to be able to do, is conquer some fears. Like, I have quite a few. I have fears that are really, some of them are like very crazy. Honest, not really crazy, because it's not crazy to be afraid of something. It's that some of them are just, I don't know why I'm afraid of them. So I'm going to use the Smashbox and Vlada highlighter. So this one right here, I'm going to tap into with this brush. I'm just going to give myself a little highlight. I'm going to do the highlight before I do the blush, just because I like to make it go underneath sometimes. You can do it however you choose, though. I mean, everybody does makeup a little bit different, which is fine. That's what makes makeup fun, because it's all about playing with it. But anyway, I would love to learn how to get over some fears that I have, because I have quite a few that are, have, some of them have made me change the way that I live, to be honest with you. So, and I would love to learn how to like overcome fears. If you guys have any tips or suggestions, let me know for sure. Okay, now I'm going to go into this Lancome. This is the Haute Couture Little Blush. I purchased this myself. This was not sent to me by Lancome, but this is a really, or I think it might have come into a subscription box. I'm not even positive, to be honest with you. So just going to put a little bit of that on my cheeks. I'm going to have to blend out, because that's really pigmented. And this brush might have had a little bit of bronzer on it. So I'm going to blend that out a little bit here. I like to bring it up like to my cheekbone up there. I don't know about you guys, but I just think it makes my cheeks look, my, I guess, is that your cheekbone? What the heck bone is that? I don't know. Anyway, I like to bring it up just because I feel like it really does help to kind of like smooth, not really smooth, like elongate your face. So my face doesn't look so this way. It looks more longer. Does that make sense? Anyway, now I'm going to line my lips. I'm going to use the Smashbox Always Sharp Lip Liner, and this is in Crimson. I'm going to use this. Maybe, oh, it twists open. That's why I couldn't open it. I'm like, why is this not working? So I'm going to use this because I'm going to use a red lipstick. And you guys have mentioned that if I use a liner, that will definitely help. So we'll try this. We'll try it out. Sorry, guys. Got real quiet, didn't it? Got real awkward there for a second. I'm not even good at lip liner. Look at this. This is like horrible. Now I understand when they tell you to stay inside the lines in kindergarten. I couldn't speak, because I can't stay inside the lines. Are you supposed to like color it all the way in? Because I feel like this looks really interesting. I mean, by weird. I think I should color it in a little bit, don't you think so? No? I don't know. we go. It's good enough. Now I'm going to use the lipstick from Lancome that was sent to me complimentary from them and also Octoly. So here is the color. This is a really beautiful red. I am not a deep, dark lipstick lover. You guys probably know that by now because I'm not good with lipsticks. I'm always going to get it on my teeth. But I have heard like the finger trick and have heard two lip lines. So we're going to try these little tricks out and see what happens. So I've got it on. So let's do the finger trick because I have heard that works. So basically with the finger trick, if you've never seen it before, basically you put your finger in your mouth and you pull it out and then whatever lipstick's on there is not gonna then get on your teeth. So let's do the finger trick. Okay, so the lipstick that's on my hand would have gotten onto my teeth, supposedly. So I'm just gonna wipe that onto this makeup eraser, my really cute one that's got these little, what are these, flamingos? I couldn't think of what they were called for a second, flamingos. Okay, I'm going to finish up my eye look quickly. I'm going to put a little bit of this brown shade. I think this one here is like a purpley brown on my lower lash line. And I also want to put an inner corner highlight. So we're going to do both of those things quickly. So I'm going to use this brush right here. I'm going to use this shade, which is Dusk. And I'm just going to, wrong brush. That is a brow brush. That is not the brush I was looking for. Told you guys, my brushes are all messed up. So I'm going to use this one right here. This is a Royal Langnickel one. All right, now this might work better. The other one was much too stiff and it felt like I was poking my eyeballs out. So this one works much better. I think I want to go ahead and put a little bit more shimmer on my lid as well. So I'm going to go back into the same shade, which was Starcrossed. I'm going to use the same brush I just used. Ooh, I think I might have gone in a little too heavy-handed there. I'm just going to put a little bit more of this onto the lid here, onto the center part and in a little bit, just to give it a little bit more of some definition. And there we go. There's that one. Now I'm going to highlight my inner corner and I'm going to go back into the Smashbox and Vlada palette. So I'm going to tap my finger into that and just put that in the inner corner here. Okay, I'm done. You guys have to tell me, what do you think of the bright red lip? Is it me? Is it not me? I don't know. Can I pull it off? I'll have to see. My husband will get to see this bright red lip soon. The only thing is, how do you kiss somebody when you get this bright red lipstick on? Isn't it going to get all over them? Maybe that's a good idea. So that's what I'll do. I'll just put plants a couple kisses all over his cheeks so he'll walk around with red lipstick. So not a bad idea. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed today's Get Ready With Me. I am going to be doing an un-Get Ready With Me very soon for you guys, so I'm going to try to do it maybe tonight. Maybe I'll take my stuff with me to the camper and do it there. I'm not sure, but either way, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Let me know if you've tried any of these products out. If you've enjoyed them, let me know how you felt about any of them. Thank you guys so much for watching, and until next time, I'll catch you guys later.